Today we have with us Sanjay Jha. So we are here to talk about Sanjay Jha's new book, The Great Unraveling, India After 2014. Before I ask you a few things about the book, and before I open you to subscribers' questions, I must say you have managed to garner criticism from BJP supporters and Congress supporters. So congratulations for that.
Yeah, I mean, that is an extraordinary feat, I'm telling you. To get badgered from both sides, I have to be the ultimate masochist the world has ever seen.
I found it interesting that people who were loyal to Congress were criticizing you with same viciousness as did the BJP supporters. How did that make you feel?
Well, you know, it just basically told you how polarized India has become today, basically, Chadol. You know, if you look at the conversations, you know, I mean, today, either you are for an X cause or anti the X cause.
Yep.
Nobody in India today is bothered about the fact that a majority of our lives are lived in the gray area. You know, you agree with one person one day, you disagree with them another. And that's the way life is meant to be. So I do believe that both the Congress and the BJP are responsible. I think BJP more than the Congress for polarizing this country. As a result, when I question the Congress, a party I'm still part of, by the way,
yep.
I'm there as a animated suspension or suspended animation, choose what you like. The Congress doesn't like my outspokenness. The BJP believes that I'm outrageous. It doesn't matter. As long as I believe I'm batting for the values that India should fight for.
Clarify this for me. You are technically still in the Congress, but you're not there. So what is All India Professionals Congress?
Well, that was an effort made by the Congress Party to reach out to the urban professionals in India. So the idea was that the Congress Party has lost the connect, you know, with the rising aspirational millennial crowd of India, which is a fact, by the way, because, you know, honestly, Mr. Modi seems to have captured the imagination of the young. And therefore, the Congress Party started the Professionals Congress. Because I happen to be, you know, having worked in banks and mutual funds, I am a corporate guy, even as I talk to you today. I do have a corporate consulting firm. And, you know, I honestly believe it is a good effort on the part of the Congress to do that.
While reading the book, you know, I felt that I was between the perspectives of two people. Sanjay Jha, the citizen who's worried about the country and who's noticing all this. And the book is more or less a commentary on these 6-7 years. And Sanjay Jha, the congressman. Who I thought had some blinders, still had some blinders about the Congress. And it's best reflected on your view of Congress as an egalitarian, idealistic organization, which has faltered a bit. But this is what you essentially say in the Congress chapter, right?
Yeah.
And I think you're wrong there. And I needed to make a comment on that, that it began in 69. This is not the original Congress, and during Mandal especially, when all those groups broke out. And I see that as a dichotomy between you as a congressman and you as a citizen.
Shardul, see, there is no denying that the Congress Party began its descent or decline or disintegration almost after Mrs. Gandhi announced or proclaimed the emergency. You know, we came back in 1980, I agree. Won 404 seats in 1984, I agree. But the Congress really has never been the same after the 1989 Lok Sabha election. After 1984, the Congress has never got an absolute majority. It's 36 years. We haven't been voted with the public mandate to govern the country on our own. Clearly, there's been a disconnect.
In the book, you talk a lot about how BJP is pushing its ideology, and we at News Laundry and every, you know, honest journalist out there is criticizing the government of today's government.
Yeah.
But the governance loopholes which have been left in this country, sadly, during the Congress regimes, people have not had anything. So when they get a guy like Modi, who's, you know, assertive, vociferous, but he gets them something delivered. You know, ideology is one thing, but the logistics of politics, the Congress seems to have lost the plot on it ages ago.
You know, a lot of the laws that the BJP is exploiting today, whether it's against the media that you are part of, Shardul, or for example, attacking the JNU students and calling them seditious. I mean, many of the laws were introduced by us. And, you know, when you introduce a law, and I don't say that, you know, the laws were introduced just to kind of harass people. There were certain issues maybe of external aggression or internal security, there is always a challenge in a country. But you have to know that if those laws fall into the hands of somebody who's a demagogue or authoritarian, then India becomes susceptible. And I do believe that both political parties will come and go, but the government or the country remains forever.
I don't know how many people know, you've written a cricket anthology. I didn't know. Yeah. 11 Triumphs, Trials and Turbulence, Indian Cricket, and 2003-2010, right?
Yep.
So what's your point of view about this series which happened, Australia won? Forget politics for a while. Because many people say it's the greatest of all time. And I'm not that big of a cricket fan. So how true is it?
If you look at India's performance in Australia, the Brisbane Test victory, the fact that India wins without even having a fully fit team, the big star Virat Kohli is not there, Shami is not playing, Ishan Sharma is not playing. It tells you that, you know, to win, all you need is spunk. You need that spirit. You need that heart. You know, if you don't believe you can win, you're not going to win it. And I'll tell you something here. And I want to link this to politics. You know, the reason why the BJP wins, and I know a lot of people in the Congress make fun of Amit Shah's Mission 300 or 200, depending upon which state the BJP is fighting. But what it does is it gives the BJP a goal. You know, supposing your leader begins to say that in the next Lok Sabha, we'll win 400 seats. It doesn't matter if they don't get 400. If they get even 200, they form the government. But you see, it galvanizes your workers. In my opinion, leadership is about inspiring your people into believing in the narrative, your story. And I do feel that this is the difference between the Congress and the BJP.
Mufat khoro, muft mein itna ich milega. To watch the full unedited interview, you have to subscribe to News Laundry and pay to keep news free. Because when the public pays, the public is served. We depend on you and not on advertisers. So go to www.newslaundry.com/subscription and subscribe and get all our unedited interviews, our special video shows, comics, and everything that's behind the paywall. Remember, to subscribe to News Laundry, you pay just about 10 rupees a day. That's less than, well, no, a cigarette. And smoking is injurious to health. So subscribe and watch the full interview.
Yeah, go ahead, guys. I'm ready.
Let the roast of Sanjay Jha begin.
What would be the first priority of Congress?
But why would the Gandhis be so blind to the reality?
Why should the Congress be a major player anymore?
Why do a section of the leadership not want a change in the party?
Absolutely bang on, yeah. If the Congress party cannot read the papers, doesn't watch the kind of program we are doing today, doesn't read Twitter, doesn't engage with the people, can't see what the people are telling you, then man, if you want to self-destruct, why should your opponent even bother to kill you? I don't think Indian democracy is even in the ICU. It has already gone into a coffin. If anybody here wants to be self-delusional, be my guest.
And how that perception can be changed?
Well, you know, Abdul, you have raised a very relevant point. In my opinion, the Congress party should have defended this argument very well that the BJP is going to make as part of its political rhetoric. You know, one thing which didn't happen under the Congress but is happening under the BJP is that people are so scared that now we are self-censoring. But you never know in politics how things change. Huh? I've seen it, okay? So if things change, a new leader comes in and the Congress actually begins to believe it can win, boom, you never know what can happen.